Hey, what's up, everyone? My name is Aaron Tandem. I'm one of the coaches at Empowered Strength, and we are also responsible for teaching the strength training classes here out at Pronghorn Resort. So I wanted to take the time with this video to walk you guys through one of the basic movements that we use at Empowered Strength, and it's called the kettlebell swing. This is one of the best moves for developing overall athletic potential and power, and it's also going to help you improve simple things like your golf game and whatnot. So the kettlebell swing looks like so. So that might look a little intimidating at first, but I'm going to take the time today, like I said, to walk you through all the steps to help you build up to doing this movement as well as you should. And here they are. So the first step to learn the kettlebell swing, before you even get into the ballistic swing part of the movement, is learning how to do the deadlift or the hip hinge pattern. And before we even get to that pattern, it's important to know whether you have the mobility to actually handle it. So a quick little assessment you can do to make sure is, can you touch your toes? Are you able to keep your legs mostly straight, bring your fingers down to your feet without any sort of pain in your low back, your hamstrings, or outright uncomfortability? If you can do that, then you're ready for the next step. So a lot of people make mistakes when it comes to the deadlift or hip hinge pattern in that they think it's some sort of squat. People hear, like, you know, lift with your legs, not your back, and people think that means lifting something like this. This is what we call a squat pattern. It's where we're moving up and down. A deadlift is where we're moving out and back. So instead, our hips are moving this way. We're loading most of the back of our legs, our posterior chain, our hamstrings, and our glutes. And these are the muscles we use to lift up a weight from the floor. This is what you call the deadlift or hip hinge pattern. You want to make sure you master this pattern before you move on to kettlebell swing, otherwise you're putting the cart before the horse. Couple points. I don't want to spend all day on this, but I do want to give you a general idea of what to look for. Remember, your back stays nice and straight and neutral the entire time. Your knees don't go too far forward the entire time. And you want to make sure that you are using these muscle groups. If you feel a light stretch happening in these areas, you're probably doing it right. And it looks like so. So there you have it, that's a very basic idea of the deadlift or hip hinge pattern. So after you've done the handle of the hip hinge or deadlift position, what's next in the kettlebell swing is doing the hike, which is where we bring the kettlebell back to the loaded position at the bottom of the kettlebell swing, and we're just going to practice that by itself. So at this point, I'm going to come out at a little bit of an angle so you can see things from multiple sides. And the hike position is going to bring a lot of memories back. If you ever played football or if you ever seen people play football, it looks just like when the person at the front of the line is sending the ball back to the quarterback. And it looks like so. You're coming down in hip hinge position, grab the bell with both hands, and you're just going to use a little bit of momentum from the bell being slightly in front of you to bring that bell right up between your legs as high as you can. The higher the bell goes, the better. So, seeing it from this side as well. Looks just like that. This is the kettlebell hike. And this is also where it's very important to point out that the kettlebell, when you're doing the swing, as opposed to the deadlift position, the deadlift, the bell is directly underneath you. And the kettlebell swing, and the hike as well, the kettlebell is in front of you, about a foot or so. So that's what allows you to really make sure that this angle from your arms grabbing the kettlebell allows it to swing back to the beginning of that movement. That is the kettlebell hike. So next, after we figured out the hike, which is the first part of the kettlebell swing, you would think we'd actually move on to doing the rest of the kettlebell swing. But what we actually want to do is pretend to do movement with no kettlebell. Pretend that we just have a kettlebell in our hands and we're just going to go through the flow of the movement. Because for whatever reason, when most people try to do the full movement with the kettlebell itself, it tends to throw things a little bit out of whack. So you're going to pretend you have a kettlebell, just set it off to the side real quick. You're going to set up just like you're going to do that hike position. And what I want you to pretend is you're hiking that bell back like we just did. And right here, you want to stand as explosively as you can. And at this moment is when your hips meet your hands, and your hands bring up with your arms in a nice explosive pattern. And you want to practice that slowly at first. It looks like And as you get more comfortable with the pattern, it's when you speed it up to really make it look like that explosive kettlebell swing itself. Only then, once you feel like you've gotten the handle of that movement pattern, can we bring the kettlebell back, get set up for the hike, and practice the full thing. This is a dead start swing. Bring the bell down every single repetition. So that you give yourself a chance to reset in between every single practice rep so that you can get that as well as you can. That is the dead start kettlebell swing. Now, the final step to putting the kettlebell swing completely together is, as you might already guess, we're now going to make all the repetitions consecutive like you saw in that first video. And it looks like so. That is what the final culmination of all these steps is going to build up to and make the kettlebell swing look like the way that it should. So, final few caveats when it comes to that movement is that you don't want to think of this movement as a typical lifting bench press or squat movement where you're really kind of controlling the weight on the way down and pushing back up. There is a little bit of a nice, relaxed, ballistic nature to it that you just let it float up and you let it flow back down without you feeling like you have an outright knee to lower. But watch these videos again as you're building up to your kettlebell swing. But one of the things that we're going to be talking about in our next few blog posts and next few videos is that there are a lot of small mistakes that you can make with this movement. I don't expect you to have this completely figured out just through this basic tutorial. In our next series, we're actually going to walk you through common mistakes and how to fix them so that you can make your kettlebell swing as perfect and as safe as you need to be for your practice. You'll look forward to that next, but final recommendations, you should see it in the writing below. That men, I wouldn't go any heavier than a 16 starting out. Women, I wouldn't be going any higher than a 12. And that is in kilograms, which is the kettlebells that we have here at Concord. So I'm using a 16 kilogram right here. Women, there are 12 kilograms off to the side. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out and we can answer them to the best of our ability.